Fanciful Stories. Narration, Katie Haigh. White Magic. Blind folk see the fairies, oh, far better than we, who miss the shining of their wings because our eyes are filled with things we do not wish to see. They need not seek enchantment from solemn printed books, for all about them as they go the fairies flutter to and fro with smiling friendly looks. Dear folk hear the fairies, however soft their song. 'Tis we who lose the honey sound amid the clamour all around that beats the whole day long. But they, with gentle faces, sit quietly apart. What room have they for sorrowing, while fairy minstrels sit and sing close to each listening heart? From London, Punch. Fanciful Stories. Narration, Katie Haigh. The Brownies by Juliana Horatia Ewing.
Children are a burden, said the tailor, as he sat on his bench stitching away.
Children are a blessing, said the kind lady in the window.
It was the tailor's mother who spoke. She was a very old woman and nearly helpless. All day she sat in a large armchair knitting rugs.
What have my two lads ever done to help me? Continued the tailor sadly. They do nothing but play. If I send Tommy on an errand, he loiters. If I ask him to work, he does it so unwillingly that I would rather do it myself. Since their mother died, I have indeed had a hard time.
At this moment, the two boys came in, their arms full of moss, which they dropped on the floor.
Is there any supper, Grandmother? Asked Tommy.
No, my child, only some bread for breakfast tomorrow.
Oh, Grandmother, we're so hungry!
And the boys' eyes filled with tears.
What can I do for you, my poor children? Said the good woman.
Oh, tell us a story, please, so that we can forget we're hungry. Tell us about the brownie that used to live in your grandfather's house. What was he like?
Like a little man, they say.
What did he do?
He came early in the morning before anyone in the house was awake, and lighted the fire, and swept the room, and set out the breakfast. He never would be seen, and was off before they could catch him. But they often heard him laughing and playing about the house.
Did they give him any wages, Grandmother?
No, my dear, he did the work for love. They always set a pan of clear water for him, and now and then a bowl of bread and milk.
Oh, Grandmother, where did he go?
The old owl in the woods knows. I do not. When I was young, many people used to go and see the old owl at moonrise and ask her what they wanted to know.
Oh, how I wish a brownie would come and live with us, cried Tommy. So do I, said Johnny.
Will you let us set out a pan of water for the brownie, Father? Asked Tommy.
You may set out what you like, my lad, but you must go to bed now.
The boys brought out a pan of water. Then they climbed a ladder to the loft over the kitchen. Johnny was soon in the land of dreams, but Tommy lay awake, thinking how he could find a brownie and get him to live in the house.
There is an owl that lives in the grove, he thought. It may be the old owl herself. When the moon rises, I'll go and find her.
The moon rose like gold and went up in the heavens like silver. Tommy opened his eyes and ran to the window.
The moon has risen, said he. It's time for me to go.
Downstairs he crept softly and out into the still night.
Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo!
Cried a voice from the grove near the house.
That's the old owl, thought Tommy.
He ran to a big tree and looked up. There he saw the old owl, sitting on a branch and staring at him with yellow eyes.
Oh dear,
said Tommy, for he did not like the owl very well.
Come up here, come up here, she cried.
Tommy climbed the tree and sat face to face with her on the big branch.
Now, what do you want?
Said the owl.
Please, said Tommy, I want to know where to find the brownies and how to get one to come and live with us. Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.